Welcome, ladies and gentlemen. It's Pixelated All Paulo. Thanks for stopping by. Hope you guys are doing well. And we are back playing the Seven Kingdoms mod for Total War Attila. This is a 2v2 online pitch battle. You know, it's been a while since the last time we did a proper pitch battle, so it's great to be back doing another pitch battle. We mostly been doing siege battles. But before we get started with this fight, I do have some very exciting news about this mod. First off, I want to let you know, in case you didn't know, is that they recently updated the mod, so we're just kind of testing out how it plays. It does play out a lot differently because they're trying to balance it. They're messing with the stats, making it more fair and balanced. Also, they changed the name of some of the units, so it's no longer heavy infantry, medium infantry, light infantry. It's more like heavy knights, levies. It makes it a little bit more immersive, which is pretty cool. The next thing I want to talk about is the really exciting part. I was talking to one of the developers of this mod. He was showing me pictures of new characters that are coming out very soon, and they look identical to the characters from the show. Very cool stuff. Also, he is letting me know that the Wildlings and the Night's Watch are almost done. So I don't know if they're gonna come out in the next patch or maybe the next patch, but whatever the case, I'm excited for it. We're gonna do a lot of classic Night Watch versus Wildling battles, siege battles, pitch battles in the snow, of course. It's gonna be a lot of fun. Also, because we have the Wildlings, we're gonna be able to do part two of our mini Game of Thrones series. You know, part one is where Jackie Fish betrayed me as House Bolton. Well, Jon Snow, he's gonna rally some Wildlings. Of course, he's gonna have some Black Watch and House Stark troops with him as well. It's gonna be a fun part two. Hopefully, Jon Snow can get revenge. You never know in this game, anything can happen. So on that note, let's now look at these armies and check out the army comps and of course get the battle started. All right, so on one side, we have House Tyrell commanded by Jackie Fish, and I am commanding the Riverlands. I have actually multiple houses in my army, mostly consisting of House Bracken, but I do have a lot of troops from House Tully, and unfortunately, I have some troops from House Frey. Boo. I just, you know, I got him for diversity's sake, I guess. Whatever, I felt bad for him. Not really, I don't care. And then we're taking on House Aaron here, which is just one of my favorite factions in this game. I mean, how do you look at those uniforms and be like, meh, these uniforms are amazing? You're more like, oh wow, those are great uniforms. And plus the blue and white, I love that color scheme, obviously. So, and then finally helping House Aaron, we have House Lannister, which I think Lionheart should really appreciate House Lannister. I mean, it screams Lionheart. You got the lion, the red and gold. It's pretty cool stuff. All right, so let's look at the army comps. We're gonna go into slow motion just to make sure we don't miss any of this fight. The pitch battles are extremely fast. I'm definitely gonna be doing a lot of slow motion throughout the fight. Let's start with my army first. So House Tully, I have some longbows in the front line, and I gotta make sure I say Tully, not Tully, because apparently I was saying Tully the first time I was playing as House Tully, so yeah, people got triggered there. But yeah, I've got some longbows in the front, 5 units of longbows, and then for my infantry, I have the dismounted Bracken Knights with swords. They're my heavy infantry. They're ready to go. I've got some pikes in the back. I do have some Frey Outriders. Boo, they suck. And then I have 2 units of the dismounted Frey Knights. Boo. And then over on this side, I am bringing some more knights, heavy knights from House Tully. And I have some spears. I think about 4 or 5 units of spears. They're going to be on the flanks helping the cav in their cav engagements. And that's pretty much it for my army. Of course, I have the Blackfish on my side, which, look at the model. Look at that. That looks, it's amazing. Who's doing the faces for this mod? I mean, it's just spot on. It's crazy insane. Let's now look at Tyrell, again, commanded by Jackie Fish. He's got some longbows in the front, about 4 or 5 units, I think 4 units. And then he's got some Tyrell men-at-arms as a medium infantry. He's got his heavy infantry, Tyrell, dismounted Tyrell knights. These guys look amazing as well. They look really cool, very professional, almost like Roman. And then he has more knights in the back. He has a onager. He has Mace Tyrell. And on the flank, he's got his heavy knights. He's got some spears supporting his cav. Very sneaky of Jackie. And he also has more men-at-arms in front of the cav as, you know, a nice infantry support. Let's now look at the opposing forces, starting with House Aaron. He's got spears in the front line protecting his archers. He's got about 4 units of crossbowmen. He's got more spears in the secondary line, again, protecting his archers. He's bringing some pikemen in the back. Very nice cloaks. I like that. Like that style. He's got his army in a very strange formation. He's got his heavy infantry on the wings instead of the center line. He's got his men-at-arms swords. I believe this is the medium infantry. And then he has the heavy infantry which are in like a testudo. They look really cool. He's got about, what, 4 or 5 units. Very nice. And then, of course, he has his heavy cav. He's got about 4 or 5 units of the Aran Knights. And here is his general, which is Jon Royce. And we'll now move on to House Lannister, where he's got 3 units of longbowmen. He's got some Lannister men-at-arms. He's bringing some spearmen, men-at-arms spearmen. He's also bringing about 4 units of crossbows. So he's got a lot of skirmishers, 2 catapults or 2 onagers, 2 units of pikemen. He has Jaime Lannister. So let me show you Jaime Lannister. There he is. Very cool. The last time I showed you the incorrect, not Jaime Lannister version. It was just some random dude. This is actually Jaime Lannister. His head looks a little big, but it looks great. In the very back, he's got some outriders. He's actually got a lot of outriders. That's really the most of his army. I think he's got like 6-7 units of outriders. It's insane. But he also has some Lannister knights with his outriders. So that's it for the army comps. We can now get started with the battle. All right, so let's talk a little bit strategy, or a little bit of the strategy that we're going to talk about here. So House Lannister, like I said earlier, they're very defensive skirmish focus. He's going to try to beat Jackie Fish by just shooting him to death with the support of the onagers and the archers. He also has these skirmish cavs, so I could read him like a book. Now, I'm not the best Total War player. I'm sure most of you guys know that. I think I'm pretty decent, you know? Come on, throw me a bone. But I was looking at his army as like, Jackie, he's just going to sit back and try to skirmish you to death. And then he's going to push forward the outriders and try to harass you and make you make a quick decision and a bad decision. So I said, let's just be aggressive. That's the best way to fight these kind of armies. You don't want to sit back and try to beat them through a skirmish. It's just not going to happen. And with the cav, with the outriders, he's not going to engage Jackie's cav. So I think the best thing to do with skirmish cav is just to ignore them. Just ignore them, because if you defeat his main army and all he has is skirmish cav, it's not going to win the battle. So if you take out his main force, don't worry about the outriders. I did send over 2 units of my outriders. I know it's not a huge help, but it's just something to try to zone out his outriders, even though he's taken on like 5-6 units of outriders. It's insane. I'm now pushing up my archers, and this battle is about to go underway. My longbows are in position. I think his are in range as well. I actually sent over one of my archers to help with House Lannister because he has so many skirmishers. Catapults are now firing, so I'm trying to soften them up a little bit. Look at these crossbows. They look great. House Aaron. One of my favorite. You know what? I'm going to call it, guys, my favorite house. Just because I like their style. You know, style points are all that matter to me. All right, so we're getting a couple kills. That poor soul is dead. Took an arrow to the, looks like the neck. That's brutal. But his crossbows, I guess, are not quite in range. He is moving up his cav and his heavy infantry. When I first saw this formation, let's do a tactical view here, where you can see his heavy infantry right here on the wings. I really didn't know how to approach this because I've never really seen this before. But hold on. There we go. Okay, sorry. I always get stuck in that tactical view. But what I was going to say is, like, I'm just going to stick to my guns. I'm just going to do what I know best and be aggressive here with Jackie Fish. The outriders are moving out to try to get in a better position. He does have his heavy cav with him to try to protect him just in case he has to send in the heavy cav. Now, Jackie Fish, he's going to do his best to try to outrun these outriders. But honestly, the outriders are not that fast. For a skirmish cav, they're really not that quick, so it's not going to be that big of a deal. We'll see what happens, though, during this battle. All right, so more archers are being pushed forward. Lannister longbows, which I believe are in range. What do we got over here? We actually have some cav. He's trying to charge some of my archers. You can see he's trying to sneak some Aran knights there. Aran, oh my god. But I was able to zone him out with my knights. I was well prepared for that. I was not going to have that, so I'm retreating my Tully knights. They're falling back. So I was able to zone them out. My archers are still going to town, and they are kicking butt, guys. I mean, we've really wrecked this unit. We are winning the skirmish, and that's a really good sign, especially since we're probably not going to win on this front. Jackie Fish is getting some pretty good hits with the artillery, killing some of the Lannister men-at-arms. And he's got his... Oh, we got returning fire. Let's see if he gets any hits here. Oh, it looks, oh, he's taking out the artillery, and he does get some fantastic hits on the artillery and the infantry, and then he just takes out another catapult there, and just like that, Jackie Fish is in a terrible position, and he is now advancing his men because he cannot sit back any longer. I told him just to ignore the outriders. I'll zone him out with my two outriders, hopefully to just delay House Lannister as the infantry win the day. We also see that House Arryn is also well, he's got his infantry pushed up a little bit, and I decided to push up some spears with Jackie Fish. Whenever your ally is pushing up, you never want to leave him hanging because his flanks will be exposed. I'm now also pushing up my army. Here we go. My pikes are leading the way. They're going to push down the center. Even though he has most of his infantry on the flanks, he kind of repositioned them more into the center. All right, let's do slow-mo. This is getting too intense, guys. All right, so I decided to fall back a little bit, but unfortunately, the great Knights of the Vale, they're going to be able to catch up onto my knights, but I do have some spear support close behind. Unfortunately, he is also sending some spear support, so it's a pretty even match right here, but I think I have the edge because I have some more cav than he does. Here's another charge. Look at this fight. This is awesome. This is fantastic. Fan-freaking-tastic. This is wonderful. So charges, I think, are a lot more important in this mod. You want to get that early aggressive charge on your opponent. That's going to really help you out in the prolonged melee. And look at the background. You see the cav fighting. The background, there's just thousands of troops marching across the battlefield. I love it. All right, so let's fly over here. See that House Tyrell is getting super close to House Lannister. And Lannister's formation is a really bizarre one. He's got spaces here, which is not a good thing because Jackie Fish will be able to just run right through that gap and then flank around the Testudo men-at-arms. We do have a pretty massive cav engagement going on at this side as well. Lannister's sending some spears to try to support their cav, but it doesn't look like it's going to be enough. And like I was saying, the Outriders, they're not that fast. They're really not that fast, so Jackie Fish was able to catch, he was able to cut him down with his heavy cav. That's insane. So they might want to speed up the Outriders a little bit. I don't know if you can do that or what, but I think they should. My Outriders are just holding their ground. I am killing most of the Lannister Outriders, the ones that engage me here. Oh yeah, get wrecked! Alright, fantastic. But he's still flanking around, I think, some heavy cav here. So he's completely ignoring this main engagement here, which he is losing. Oh, we got some archers that are about to be charged. Let's do normal speed here. Oh, hold your ground, archers. You're the longbows. He uses fire arrows to try to break them. Wasn't that great of a charge. These are Outriders, so it's not like they have super impressive cav charges. The infantry have now engaged. You can see they're already breaking some forces here and there. House Lannister versus House Tyrell. Again, we're going to do slow motion. I'm sorry, guys, but I just can't do normal speed. I want to try to capture everything going on. Wait, what's going on over there? I see, like, troops on fire. Oh, no, no. It's just House Frey. House Frey holding the flank here. Got to respect House Frey in that regard. We were able to cut down some of his cav. You can see that he actually did a tactical retreat, which I think that really hurt him in the long run. So he was able to fall back. But, you know, with my cav, I'm going to keep pushing. Actually, I'm falling back. I think I'm waiting for spears, but technically, I'm still going to push here soon, but I really want to focus on the infantry fight where this is kind of messy. There's no proper formation. There's just kind of pockets of troops fighting everywhere, but I'm definitely, it's a pretty even fight here. My artillery's still going to town, just going for the reserves in the back, going for the crossbows. This main line here is actually going quite well, even though if you look, I'm actually quite surrounded, but I've got a lot of troops that are not even fighting yet. Look at this. They're just waiting in reserve. They're in Testudo formation. But I'm now going to advance them. We're going to do normal speed. So I'm advancing them. Trying to get around the flank of House Arryn. And more infantry. My pikes are charging into the front line. Supporting House Frey. They're heavy infantry. I don't even know why I would help them. But whatever. Oh, that's right, because I'm trying to win the battle. And then here's more swordsmen charging in. We got another small flank engagement. Just pockets of fighting everywhere. I mean, this is so intense. Like, there's so much stuff going on right now. It's actually quite challenging to commentate. You can see some of his cav. He retreated some of his cav to help him out on this flank. Actually gets a pretty solid charge on Jackie Fish's heavy infantry. So we'll go back to normal speed. Now his infantry is going to be able to hold shit. This is where the heavy infantry really excel at. They're going to be able to form up a nice tight formation and slaughter the cav in prolonged melee. All right, so let's... I'm so worried. Like, I want to get some great close-ups, but I'm worried that you guys won't really have a full understanding of what's going on. And these pitch battles, man. Oh, someone lost his head. But yeah, these pitch battles are so fast. It's insane. But yeah, more and more fighting. Lannister slowly getting pushed back. Jackyfish using his infantry to really penetrate the lines here. Again, he had this weird gap formation, which really hurt him in the long run. And let's see what's happening here. Jackyfish able to cut down most of those outriders because he was able to catch them. You know, once you catch outriders, they do not stand a chance against the heavy cav. So now they're going to try to flank around. And this is where the battle's starting to look really good. The balance of power is still dead even, but we won the cav engagement. We have the cav advantage, which is almost like, I would say like 95% of the time when you have the cav advantage, you're going to win. But we've got a very intense cav charge on this side. House Aaron is trying to turn this one around. I've got House Tully here. Tully, who is trying to hold their ground. We do have the general in the mix as well, but he's gonna disengage, fall back. He keeps doing these cycle charges, which are only helping me in the long run. But my men are now going to just ignore that calf. I'm not gonna chase him down. I'm actually gonna go for House Aaron's infantry. So you can see he's got very vulnerable archers in reserve. Those are a juicy target. My men are licking their lips because they're ready to slaughter these troops. Here they go, some crossbows. Oh, wait, no, they decided not to charge. Seriously, I didn't charge it to... Wait, okay, hold on. Well, okay, I guess I didn't go for the... what? All right, well, it's still a juicy target, but I just decided not to go for it, I guess. I don't know. I'm now supporting this main fight where my pikemen and House Frey are holding. I flanked around a lot of spearmen that are now free because they don't have to worry about enemy cav. I'm also holding on over here. It looks like my opponent is going to win this small engagement, but thankfully, again, I still have a lot of cav just roaming around. Knights everywhere, just trying to find any vulnerable units, trying to cut them down. You can see my general is actually in the fight now, and he is the one cutting down the archers. So I'm chopping them up. Nice Blackfish there, doing a great job. We killed the enemy general who was stuck in this prolonged engagement against my cap. We have a, look at this man. Look at this man, deserves to be in the circus. Standing on his horse like that, like a true champ. And then I'm gonna continue to pursue his cap. Let's see what's going on with House Lannister, where he's just getting swallowed whole by Jackyfish because of his heavy knights being able to flank around this main army. And now the general, Jaime Lannister. Let's see if we can find him in the front. There he is. He's now trying to fight. Let's see if he'll fight to the death or run like a coward. I'm putting my bets on run like a coward. Even though, yes, I did play this battle, but I don't quite remember what happens to Jaime. Come on, Jaime. Fight like a man. Oh, they're cheering. Why are they cheering? They shouldn't be cheering because they're getting flanked. Oh, and now he's surrounded. Jaime Lannister is surrounded. Come on. Oh, he's getting like triple teamed right here. Oh, now infantry's pouring in. Spearmen. He's like, oh, those are spears. I should probably disengage here, but I'm just going to continue to prance around. Not really do anything. Not really kill anyone. Just kind of look around, observe the battle. Oh, he's dead. He is dead, and that is the general. He's gone. We completely shattered House Aaron and their army. It's really down to us Lannister, who has some pikemen who are getting outflanked. Oh, nice. Good charge there from the heavy knights. And now they're going for what's left of the infantry as they make their final stand. But their general is dead. They have been defeated, but they are going to, they're going to fight it out like true warriors. Get a warrior's death. There they go. They're breaking. They are breaking. And if we zoom out here, that looks to be all of the armies. I'm gonna now send my cav over. This is what's left of my cav. They've seen a lot of action. They lost a lot of great soldiers, but they are victorious, and that's gonna wrap up today's video. And yeah, that was a crazy one. I mean, this battle was all over the place. There's units, there's left and right cycle charges. I was trying to capture it all, but hopefully I didn't try so hard to the point where I was just moving around so much that you had no idea. Maybe I should have just focused on my battle, but really, in a nutshell, what it came down to is just the cav battle. The infantry battle between me and House Aaron was actually pretty even, but until I destroyed his cav, I was able to flank around and cause them to break. It's all about protecting your flanks in Total War. If you don't do that, you're going to lose your men pretty quickly. Now, on Jackyfish's point of view, his side, same thing. He won the cav engagement. was able to flank around and crush that very heavily skirmish army. And since he was mostly, his strategy really didn't work because he lost his cap so quickly, and Jackie Fish was aggressive, and I tried to be aggressive as well. That's what you want to do against skirmishing armies. Be aggressive, take them out, because they don't have the infantry. They put all their money into their archers. You just got to make sure you have some meat shields. You want to make sure you send up your, have like a unit of levies, put them in loose formation, charge them in first, make them absorb all the ammo so your heavy knights don't take all that, ammo in the face. But yeah, let's end the replay and look at the results here, where my army did pretty well. It's a pretty even spread. My archers, honestly, the skirmishing phase wasn't that long, so they got a decent amount of kills for the time that they were shooting. My general getting just under 100. House Frey, boo. They're getting 76, 41 kills. My spear is doing a great job. They did pretty well. I mean, for spears getting over 100 kills, that's really good. My swordsmen did well, some of them getting 115, 154. My outriders did well. I mean, House Frey delivered today. I'm sorry to say it, but House Frey delivered. And then, of course, my cab did their job. My pikes did well. And my onager didn't really get many kills. I mean, catapults don't really... Artillery and field battles don't really... do that well. But here is Jackie Fish's army. Let's see, how did he do? His infantry did great. His cav did really well. And it was pretty similar to my stats. Looking at Mr. Gingy, he was House Lannister. He was the one who focused so much on the skirmishing, where you can see, look at all these skirmishers' artillery. If you look at the kills, some of them got, let's see, one unit got 185, which is impressive, but really what hurt him here is his longbows not really delivering, so his infantry was just not able to hold against the great numbers of House Tyrell. And then now we have House Arryn, commanded by Tomato, he has a nice even spread. His cav, see, they didn't do quite as well as my cav. The fight between me and him, it was pretty even until he lost the cav battle. But yeah, that's pretty much it for the fight, guys. A nice, fun pitch battle, fairly quick, but I hope you guys enjoyed this one, and I'm pretty excited for the Wildlings and the Night's Watch, so look out for that. I'll probably make a lot of Seven Kingdoms battles when that comes out. So thank you guys so much for watching. Hope you enjoyed. If you did enjoy, be sure to leave a like, a comment, share, and of course subscribe if you want to see more epic battles. Thank you guys, and I'll see you next time.